Hello friend, today we will discuss verification of law of vibrating string using sonometer. Last part we have seen that the principle, construction and working of sonometer. Okay, by using sonometer we can verify the different law of vibrating string. There are three laws of vibrating string. Number one, law of length, law of tension and law of linear density. Today we will discuss the verification of these laws. First of all, law of length. Law of length. The fundamental frequency is inversely proportional to the length of vibrating string. Length of vibrating string. If the tension in the string and mass current length are constant. This is the first law of length. First law of vibrating string. That is law of length. This law can be verified by using sonometer. First of all, we can measure the length of string, that is L, and mass of the string. Mass of the string, capital M. Therefore, by using these two terms, that is capital M and L, we can determine small m, that is the linear density. Small m is equal to capital M upon L. Small m is equal to capital M upon L, that is the linear density we can determine. Then some tension T is fixed on the wire. Okay. Now, the wire is stretched on the sonometer. Stretched on the sonometer and some tension capital T is applied on the free end of the wire by slotting weight attached to the free end of the wire. Slotting weight attached to the free end of the wire. This T also be fixed. Okay. The length of wire L1 vibrating with same frequency N1 as that of the tuning fork is determined as follows. For the frequency N1, the length of vibrating string L1 can be calculated as follows. First of all, a light paper rider which is placed on the wire midway between two wooden bridges. Then a vibrating tuning fork or stem of vibrating tuning fork is placed on the sonometer. Okay. Then wire will be vibrating and by changing the distance between bridges without disturbing paper rider, frequency of vibration of wire is changed. By changing distance between bridges, wooden bridges, without disturbing this paper rider, frequency of vibration is changed. Frequency of vibration is changed. When the frequency of this wire is exactly equal to the frequency of tuning fork. Then the wire vibrate with maximum amplitude. When the frequency of this wire is exactly equal to the frequency of tuning fork, then the wire vibrate with maximum amplitude. Then the paper rider thrown off. At that time, the length between two bridges is the vibrating length L1. For the frequency N1. In this way, a set of tuning fork having different frequencies N1, N2, N3 are used and corresponding vibrating length of wire are noted as L1, L2, L3 and so on by keeping tension T in the string and mass current length are constant. We'll observe that N1 into L1 is equal to N2 into L2 is equal to N3 into L3 and so on are constant. This product is constant and therefore in general we can written as NL is equal to constant. NL is equal to constant. The product of frequency and vibrating length are constant. Or the fundamental frequency is inversely proportional to L. N is inversely proportional to L. if mass current length and tension in the string are constant. Okay, thus the first law of vibrating string, that is the law of length, is verified. Now the verification of second law. Second law, the fundamental frequency is directly proportional to the square root of tension in the string if the length of the string and mass current length are constant. Therefore, for verification of second law, the length of vibrating string, that is the length of vibrating string, that is L, and mass current length small m are constant. For verification of second law of vibrating string, the length of vibrating string L and mass current length small m are constant. By changing the tension T in the string, the same length is made to vibrate. In unison with different tuning pore of various frequency N1, N2, N3 and so on. Okay. याच्यामध्ये काय करायचं आपल्याला, length of the string and mass current length कसं ठेवायचं आहे, constant. आणि आपण tension apply करायचं, by changing the tension, change काय करायचं आपल्याला, tension. आणि same length is vibrate. Same length is made to vibrate in unison with different tuning pore of frequencies N1, N2, N3 and so on. We'll observe that N1 upon root T1 is equal to N2 upon root T2 is equal to N3 upon root T3 is equal to constant. Or we can write N upon root T is equal to constant. In this law, only change in tension and not frequency of vibrating string. Thus, N upon root T is equal to constant. Therefore, N is directly proportional to square root of T as length of the string L and mass current length are constant. This is the verification of second law of vibrating string. That is the law of tension. Now, the verification of third law, that is law of linear density. For verification of third law of vibrating string, two wires having different masses per unit length, that is small m and m2, are used. Okay, we have to use two wires of different mass per unit length, that is m1 and m2 are used. Now, the first wire is subjected to a suitable tension. First wire upon apply karu and tela kay karu thodo sa tension tela apply karu. Now the first wire is subjected to suitable tension and made to vibrate in unison with given tuning pore. The vibrating length L1 is noted. Using the same tuning pore, the second wire is made to vibrate under the same tension. The second wire made to vibrate in unison with, the tuning pore, Okay, second wire, using the same pore, the second wire is made to vibrate under the same tension and vibrating length L2 can be calculated, N2 can be determined. Thus, the frequency of vibration of two wire is kept same under the same tension T. It is found that L1 under root M1 is equal to L2 under root M2. It is also written as L into root M is equal to constant. It is found that L1 under root M1 is equal to L2 under root M2. And from this equation we can written as It is written as L into root m is equal to constant. But by first law of vibrating string, according to first law of vibrating string, the n is inversely proportional to L. N is inversely proportional to L. Therefore, N is inversely proportional to square root of M. If tension in the string and L, length of the string, are constant. This is the verification of third law.